Third day in a row, neighbor's Honda Odyssey continues. Focus, focus, camera. Oh, it shut off, but it continues to be an issue.
We may have just got the first glimpse of the first ever BRZ STI, but we're not gonna stop there today. Maz is remanufacturing parts for the legendary RX-7, Hyundai looks to be working on a ripper of an engine, and lastly, we're gonna discuss the biggest recalls of the week, like that Honda that should be recalled as well for the spontaneous alarm. Guys, make sure to smash a like button if you're excited for the upcoming BRZ and Toyota 86. And make sure you're subscribed so you don't miss any breaking news on these Toyburu brothers. Over at Car Advice Australian website, a curious BRZ has been caught testing in Japan, raising questions as to whether a hardcore version is coming. We see definitely a more modified front bumper here, some pretty sporty wheels, lots of camouflage. And why would they be having camouflage on a vehicle that's already, you know, been officially unveiled? Well, they're testing something here. My original thought would be like, oh, you know, we don't know what the 86 looks like at this point in time. Maybe they're just testing the 86. That's a small possibility. It does have a Subaru logo on it and different aerodynamics here at the bottom. Now, there's also a short video showing that it's driftable on the track, slipping out that back end there as it rounds a corner. Now, it's going to get a little bit more intense here. So this was a test day at Fuji Speedway. There was a blue BRZ spotted in the garage with a number of Subaru engineering staff wearing STI jackets. My gosh, let the speculation and the excitement begin. What are they testing? Well, more than likely it's a turbocharged version of this 2.4 liter. And that breaks us out to the spreadsheet already. It's spreadsheet time. I'm going to drink out of the LF mug to get me jazzed up for it. Okay, so the new BRZ and 86 have a beautifully enhanced, naturally aspirated, a little bit larger engine than the outgoing one, FA24 2.4 liter, a very impressive increase in power. I wasn't expecting this much power or torque, but 228 horsepower and 184 pound-feet of torque for the BRZ and the 86. The STI, it wouldn't be a WRX because that would be an all-wheel drive version. They're not gonna make an all-wheel drive version. So STI would be the outfit for the high-end trim of this vehicle. Now, that would be none other than the FA24F. Of course, we first saw it on the Ascent, but now we have it on the Legacy and Outback. And of course, it'll be seen in the upcoming WRX and STI. And this engine is supposed to be very tunable and very stout, being able to handle quite a bit of power. We've been hearing things 400 horsepower coming out of the rumor mill. So we'll have to see when it hits the STI, but I think 300 horsepower is definitely within the realm of possibilities for the WRX even. Okay, so we could see 260 horsepower more than likely if it is to come into the STI BRZ or GRMN86. Now torque, it would be an impressive minimum of 277 pound-feet of torque. As much as I'd love to see this engine come to the Toyota end, I just don't know if it's going to, because it would definitely encroach on the sales of the Supra 2.0. Doesn't have quite as much torque, but it has more horsepower, and it would offer a 6-speed manual, which the Supra doesn't. Yeah, the alarm's going off again. Don't worry, we'll get to those Honda recalls at the end of this video. Just bear with me, because you're probably going to hear this alarm on and off throughout the video today. And guys, I know you're excited for any BRZ 86 news. The thought and the hopes of an STI are alive and well. Who knows what that blue BRZ in that garage with those STI cladded engineers were doing. Let the mind imagine. Okay, let's move on. 2022 Subaru Forester facelift spied for the first time over at Motor One. Well, they're just going to change the lights, the bumpers a little bit, maybe the side cladding, the fenders as well a little bit, but we got the redesign for the 2019 model year. It's hard to believe that we're getting a facelift already. It just seems like that vehicle's still brand new to me. But 2021, so for 2022 model year, the fourth year of production, they're going to do a facelift. Well, just felt like sharing that. Not that mind-blowing or anything. Speaking of mind-blowing, though, Mazda launches heritage parts program for the FC and FD RX-7. We're over at Japanese nostalgic car. This is right up my alley here. This announcement in Japan, well, in Japan, lists 91 high-needs parts, 30 for the FC and 61 for the FD. Mazda says this is just the beginning. More will be added as the program grows. There's lots of wear and tear parts that will help keep the cars running, like vacuum hoses, throttle position sensors, and some rubber bushings and gaskets. Add fasteners as well. Mazda says the list was put together based on the input from shops that service the rotary sports cars in Japan. Now, it's pretty crazy. There's about 24,000 registered RX-7s in Japan for 2020. That's a number to wrap your head around. Now, it's possible that Mazda could include full restorations down the road, like we're seeing with the Nissan GT-R, but that'll cost you over 400 grand. But we got to keep going. Hyundai's working on a 2.3-liter turbo engine with a 7,000 RPM redline over at Motor One. Holy cow, this thing would be a screamer. This would likely find its way in tons of Hyundai products, especially with their upcoming inline. So I think that's really exciting. 2.3 liter turbo, my speculation in terms of power would be around 300 horsepower. Remember, they have a 2.5 liter turbo that's about 300 horsepower and a little over 300 pound feet of torque. So a 2.3 liter that revs really high could come close to that, maybe even surpass it, depending on how much they want to boost that engine. And if Hyundai's making it, how exciting if we got that BRZ STI to combat it. Oh man, that would be so spicy. Could you imagine that comparison? Oh my gosh, I'd love to do that for you guys. Enter the recalls as the alarm on the Honda just stopped. It actually just stopped for the 18 millionth time. Okay, Honda recalling 1.79 million vehicles over at Fox Business, and 1.4 million of those vehicles are here stateside. You might as well add the horns to it. I don't think there's a what are you supposed to do to fix that? Let me know if you guys have ever heard of an incessant alarm continuing to go off days at a time. And it seems to the frequency has been increasing. 3 days ago, I only heard it go off maybe a handful of times. And literally, since I woke up this morning, I hear it every 10 to 15 minutes. Okay, but let's get into the actual official recalls, other than the unannounced one across the street. Okay, this was announced on Tuesday. One recall, just one of the recalls, is 268,000 CRVs from 02 to 06 that replaces power window master switches. And there have been 16 fires reported from the issue. Thank God, no reported injuries. Holy smokes, literally smokes. CRVs are going up in smoke due to power window switches catching fire. Unbelievable. Honda conducted a prior recall to the Power Master switches in 2012. The new recalls in response to moisture-related failures of the switches repaired under previous campaign. Good goodness. 735,000 US 18 to 2020 Accords, Accord hybrids, and 2019 to 2020 Insight vehicles to update body control module software, a programming flaw that could disrupt communication, causing illumination of several warning lights, malfunction of electronic components, including the rear view camera display, turn signals, and windshield wipers. I feel like we had this recently on the Honda Odysseys recently as well, if I remember correctly. All right, Honda's also issuing another two recalls covering 430,000 U.S. vehicles in 22 U.S. states and the District of Columbia as well, with significant road salt used to inspect and potentially replace front drive shafts. Both are in response to possible breakage of the drive shafts due to corrosion. My goodness, no injuries have been reported, thank God, in relation to any of these recalls, the company said. Well, the Japanese are typically very aggressive with the recalls, recalling them before there have been any major safety health issues. It's not always a case, but they try to. And I would say Honda's being pretty proactive here. No injuries have been reported in relation to any of the recalls. That's a really good thing. So yes, no one's dying. No one's houses are blowing up. I think we're going to move into the next article because I just mentioned houses blowing up. Hyundai may halt South Korean sales of Kona EVs after recalls over Automotive News. Yikes. Just on the eve of them launching their new IONIQ brand, they're thinking about pulling their best-selling electric vehicle worldwide. Hyundai may end domestic sales of its full electric Kona compact crossover after a series of fires and faulty braking systems prompted mass recalls. It could potentially still sell in Europe, but they're pulling the plug in South Korea more than likely. Hyundai declined to confirm the reports, but we are reviewing various options as we prepare to launch the IONIQ 5. Tough. They got a lot of damage control here. To recap, in October, Hyundai recalled Konas in South Korea due to the risk of short circuit possibly caused by a faulty manufacturing of high voltage battery cells. The automaker also reportedly plans to recall about 51,000 Konas in North America, Europe, China, and other markets. The recall, which includes software updates and battery replacements after inspections, involves 25,000 plus Konas built during September 2017 to March 2020. And Hyundai has also recalled over 50,000 Kona and Nexa fuel cell vehicles in South Korea due to faulty electronic braking systems. Goodness. Okay, so the Honda recalls we just talked about, potentially, you know, life-threatening if the corrosion, you know, destroys a vehicle while you're driving and, you know, puts you in an accident. That's scary. As well as the window switches potentially causing fires. But this is far more scary, as your braking system could apparently just turn off, as well as we know of all the issues when it comes to the exploding Kona EVs. One of my viewers said one happened down the street for him, that a Kona EV blew up in the garage and the garage door was blasted across the street into the neighbor's yard. Pretty crazy, scary to think about. And guys, that sums up today's news. Hopefully you enjoyed it. Most exciting, guys, is just adding fuel to the fire of the BRZ STI. Ooh, just makes me, it's just like a Christmas chestnuts on the roasting on the, I can't talk right now. I haven't had coffee in about a month, and I've had some today, and it makes me feel great, but it's a little, I can't put my words together as well. If you guys haven't smashed the like button, go ahead and do that. I'll see you in the next video. Have a wonderful day. Happy holidays to you and your family. Thank you so much for everything. Peace out.